Our subject motto is Mathematics Made Simple. This is our lesson 17. Our lesson 17, we are going to look at the Pythagoras theorem. What is the Pythagoras theorem? It states that in any given right angle triangle, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the adjacent sides. So when you are given a right angle triangle, it means that it has a 90 degrees. This means 90 degrees. The opposite side is what is known as the hypotenuse, and it is the longest side. The lines next to the 90 degrees are the adjacent sides. The word adjacent means next. So those are next to the 90 degrees. So when you are given the hypotenuse, when you square it, it's supposed to be equals to the squares of the adjacent sides. Therefore, c squared is equals to a squared plus b squared. Let's look at an example. We have an example. Find the length of the unknown side using Pythagoras' theorem. So when you're asked to find the unknown side, you're supposed to identify whether it is the hypotenuse or the adjacent side. So what we are going to do is to state the Pythagoras' theorem. We are going to say a squared is equals to 3 squared plus 4 squared. So when we square the longest side, which is the hypotenuse, which is a, it should be equals to 3 squared plus 4 squared. 3 times 3 plus 4 times 4. So we are saying a squared is equals to 9 plus 16. When you multiply 3 by itself, you get a 9. Multiply 4 by itself twice, you get a 16. 9 plus 16 will give us a 25. So we are saying a squared is equals to 25. From here, introduce the square root on both sides so that we remain with a to the power 1. We know that the symbol square root means power half. Which number are you supposed to multiply by itself twice to get 25? 5. Therefore, a is equals to 5 centimeters. We continue. We have question B, which is saying find x. Find x. So before we state the Pythagoras theorem, we are supposed to identify the longest side. Our longest side is 13 and our adjacent sides are x and 5. So we'll state the Pythagoras theorem. It means 13 squared is equals to x squared plus 5 squared. From here, what we are supposed to do is to get what is on the right hand side, take it to the left, take what is on the left to the right so that the symbols are not disturbed. The signs are not disturbed. So from here, we'll transpose the 5 squared, move it from the left to the right, it will become a negative. So we are saying x squared is equals to 13 squared minus 5 squared. We'll multiply 13 by itself twice, 5 by itself twice. So we are saying 13 times 13 will give us 169. 5 times 5 is giving us 25. When we subtract 169 minus 25, we are supposed to get a 144. So we are saying x squared is equals to 144. From there, we introduce the square root on both sides. Which number are we supposed to multiply by itself twice to get 144? 12. Therefore, x is equals to 12 centimeters. We continue. We continue. We have question C, which is saying calculate B. Calculate B. So when we look at this right angle triangle, you find that our longest side is 20. So we'll state Pythagoras' theorem by saying 20 squared should be equals to b squared plus 12 squared. So we'll get what is on the right, take it to the left, and we'll take what is on the left to the right. So from here, we'll transpose the 12 squared, bring it to the right, it will become a negative. So we are saying b squared is equals to 20 squared minus 12 squared. From here, 20 times 20 minus 12 times 12 will give us b squared. When you multiply 20 by itself twice, you get 400. When you multiply 12 by itself twice, you get 144. So 400 minus 144 will give us 256. B squared is equals to 256. We introduce the square root on both sides. Square root means power half. We want to remain with b to the power 1. So if we multiply 2 times half, we'll get a 1. Therefore, our b is equals to 16. When you multiply 16 by itself twice, you get 256. Therefore, B is equals to 16 centimeters. We continue. We have the following question, which is saying calculate B. Calculate B. Now, when you look at this diagram, you find that triangle ABC has two triangles there which are right angled. We have triangle ADB and ADC. So when you are given two triangles, what you're supposed to do is to find that angle, triangle which has at least two lengths given. Look for the triangle which has two lengths given. When you use those two lengths, find the third one. Use Pythagoras' theorem to use those two sides to find the third one, which is AD. So if you look at triangle ADB, you find that our hypotenuse is 20 centimeters, our adjacent sides are AD and 16. So when we find the value of AD, we'll substitute it here to solve for B. So let's do that. So since 20 is our hypotenuse, we are going to say 20 squared is equals to AD squared plus 16 squared. We'll swap them. We'll say AD squared plus 16 squared is equals to 20 squared. We'll transpose the positive 16 squared. It will become a negative. Then we are saying 20 times 20 minus 16 times 16. If you multiply 20 by itself twice, you get a 400. Multiply 16 by itself twice, you get a 256. Subtract 400 minus 256, you get a 144. From here, we introduce the square root on both sides. Which number are we supposed to multiply by itself twice to get 144? 12. Our AD is equals to 12 centimeters. So when you find that third length, replace it, substitute it, and then use it to find what the unknown is. So we'll use 12 and 5 to find B. So we are saying B squared is equals to 5 squared plus 12 squared, since our B in the other triangle is our hypotenuse. So we are saying B squared is equals to 5 squared plus 12 squared. Multiply 5 by itself twice. Multiply 12 by itself twice. So we are having 25 plus 144. If you add 25 plus 144, you get 169. Our B squared is equals to 169. From there, what are we supposed to do? Introduce the square root on both sides. Which number are you supposed to multiply by itself twice to get 169? 13. Therefore, B is equals to 13 centimeters. As simple as that. Let's do our exercise.